Let's turn it on. That's the first tapping. Moving on to the second one. You can see the speed just doubled. The third. Hi, this is a CD or DVD player transformer. And that's my 3D printed project base stand. Link to download this design has been provided in the description. You can check it out. Now comes the polarity finding for series connection of the transformer wires. For yellow it is 11.78. Now what we have to do is try connecting these two wires together. And here as you can see that the voltage has doubled. It is 23 volts. Next comes the third set. This one. Here as you can see that the voltage has reduced, which means that this time the polarity is incorrect. So green will be connected to green. And here we have the maximum of 35.55 volts. Next comes the 35 amperes bridge rectifier and a nut bolt. Next, I'm also going to use this temperature insulation sheet to prevent heat transfer from the rectifier to the 3D printed base. Next, I will be using this 4.7 microfarad 250 volts electrolytic capacitor. After that comes your 250 volts 6 amperes diode, which will be connected to the positive output terminal of the rectifier. Next is the indicator LED and its series resistors, 1 kilo ohm each. Now, before moving on any further, let's test it. And as you can see, the output voltage is very high and fluctuating, which is useless if I want to charge a 12 volts battery. Therefore, I will have to remove this capacitor and replace it with bigger ones from this circuit. And now it is time to make a 3-pole rotary switch. Now guys, after completing the construction of the rotary switch, it is time to solder wires from the transformer and the rectifier to the switch tapping points. So guys, all the connections to the switch tapping points are complete. So let's test it. The supply is on. Let's turn the switch. So that's the first tapping, and when I'm going to move on from this point to the middle one, then the brightness should increase, indicating higher voltage. So it is brighter than before. Now moving on to the last one, which is the highest possible voltage from this transformer. More or less similar, but yes, there is a little difference. Now it is still on because the capacitors are storing the charge. So guys, the power supply is fully complete. Let's test it. For the light bulb 12 volts, I can only use the first tapping because the second and third tappings can fuse the bulb. Okay, light is glowing. I think the bulb is loose. Yeah, now it's fine. So here what we have is a 24 volts, 2 amperes printer servo motor. Let's turn it on. That's the first tapping. Moving on to the second one. You can see the speed just doubled. The third. That's the full and final one. As you can see here that even though the power supply is turned off, the meter is still displaying some fluctuating voltage. Those are the ripples. So guys, that's all for today's video, and I have already left space for the filter circuit here, which I'm going to cover in my next video. So see you in the next one. Stay connected. Bye bye.